The Network Code on Cybersecurity defines one common set of cybersecurity requirements for the European electricity sector. These requirements are the same for all EU member states. This will ensure the same level of cybersecurity protection throughout the EU, and it will help DSOs and TSOs to enhance security of the grid. This chapter on the Common Electricity Cybersecurity Framework will focus on the required cybersecurity controls, the mapping of these controls, and the cybersecurity management system.
The cybersecurity framework will be composed of the following controls and cybersecurity management system. The minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls, developed in accordance with Article 29. The mapping matrix, developed in accordance with Article 34, which maps the controls referred to in points A and B against selected European and international standards and national legislative or regulatory frameworks. And the cybersecurity management system established as per Article 32. First, let's define what we mean by high impact and critical impact perimeters. High impact perimeter means a perimeter defined by any entity listed in Article 2, Paragraph 1, that contains all high impact assets and on which access to these assets can be controlled, defining the scope where the minimum cybersecurity controls apply. Critical impact perimeter means a perimeter defined by an entity referred to in Article 2, Paragraph 1, that contains all critical impact assets and on which access to these assets can be controlled, defining the scope where the advanced cybersecurity controls apply. All high impact entities will apply the minimum cybersecurity controls. And all critical impact entities will apply the advanced and minimum cybersecurity controls within their critical impact perimeter. Now, let's explain more about minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls. In January 2027, the TSOs, with the assistance of ENTSO-E and DSO Entity, will develop a proposal for minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls. The competent authorities then have 6 months to decide the minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls based on the proposal. Then, in January 2028, the critical impact and high impact entities will apply the minimum cybersecurity controls within the high impact perimeter and advanced cybersecurity controls within the critical impact perimeter. It's worth noting that the entities may request the respective competent authority to grant a derogation from their obligation to apply the minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls. The competent authority may grant such a derogation if the entity can demonstrate that the costs of implementing the appropriate cybersecurity controls significantly exceed the benefits, or provides an entity-level risk treatment plan that mitigates the cybersecurity risks using alternative controls to a level which is acceptable with the risk acceptance criteria. The competent authority then has 3 months to decide whether a derogation from the minimum and advanced cybersecurity controls can be granted. Derogations will be granted for a maximum of 3 years, with the possibility of renewal. A provisional list of standards will be published in Q2 2025. Implementation is on a voluntary basis and could prepare entities for the minimum and advanced controls. In January 2027, the TSOs alongside ENTSO-E and DSO Entity will develop a proposal for a matrix to map the controls against selected European and international standards, as well as technical specifications. This is known as the mapping matrix. As part of this process, competent authorities may provide a map of controls relating to national legislative or regulatory frameworks, including relevant national standards of member states. If this is provided, it will be integrated into the mapping matrix. Within 6 months of drawing up each regional cybersecurity risk assessment report, the TSOs, ENTSO-E, and DSO Entity, in consultation with ENISA, will propose an amendment to the competent authority for the mapping matrix. The proposal will take into account the risks identified in the regional risk assessment. Within 24 months of being notified by the competent authority, each high-impact or critical-impact entity should establish a cybersecurity management system and review it every 3 years. Its objectives are to determine the scope of the cybersecurity management system, considering interfaces and dependencies with other entities, ensure all senior management are informed of relevant legal obligations and actively contribute to the implementation of the cybersecurity management system. Ensure the resources needed for the cybersecurity management system are available. Establish a cybersecurity policy which will be documented and communicated within the entity and to parties affected by the security risks. Assign and communicate responsibilities for roles relevant to cybersecurity. Perform cybersecurity risk management at entity level. Determine and provide the resources required for the implementation, maintenance, and continual improvement of the cybersecurity management system. Determine the required internal and external communication on cybersecurity. Create, update, and control the documented information that are part of the cybersecurity management system. Evaluate the performance and effectiveness of the cybersecurity management system. Conduct internal cybersecurity audits to ensure compliance to the requirements defined by the cybersecurity management system, and review the implementation at planned intervals to identify possible improvements. The scope of the cybersecurity management system should include all assets within the high impact and critical impact perimeter of the high impact and critical impact entity. The competent authorities shall encourage the use of European or international standards and specifications related to management systems and relevant to the security of network and information systems. Within 24 months of the adoption of the controls by the critical impact entities, these must demonstrate their compliance with the cybersecurity management system and minimum or advanced cybersecurity controls by means of independent third-party audits or, in case of the availability of a national verification scheme, through inspections by the competent authority or peer reviews.